Good morning. It is Wednesday morning. This is PeterGregg, Miami, Florida. I am in the Christmas room. I go through stuff that I need to solve sometimes, and maybe you do too. We're not going to talk about cameras today much. We're going to talk more about tripods, not microphones, not cameras, not lenses, but microphones. I will be right back.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a PeterGregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch PeterGregg.
Being a one-man band here, meaning I do everything, sometimes I need a little help, but there's no extra person. So what I have set up is a number of cameras and a whole system, and the cameras are basically sitting on tripods. This is one of the tripod heads that I use. Actually, I've got a few of them in here. And being a one-man band, I don't particularly like this one, to be honest with you. I have nothing against it. So if I have the camera and I'm standing here and the camera is on the tripod, I just loosen the screw and then I can aim it at whatever I want. See, here's what it looks like, okay? And eyes over here. This is what we're looking at. This is the tripod head, from where you see the numbers on this dial all the way to here. So if I actually remove the camera from here, I loosen a screw, I move this around and loosen a screw, and the camera comes off. Now that is what the tripod ball head looks like. Now ball heads are very, very popular. So you loosen this up like this and it stays. And you've got your little plate that slides in here, and you tighten this up right here. And that's what a ball head does. So the problem with the ball head is when I'm sitting here on my own, let's put the camera back on here, tighten it up. We don't want the cameras falling to the floor. Now, if I loosen this up just a little bit, I can move this camera around. So there you are. I'm gonna take a picture of you, okay? So I set that up the way I want. I tighten it up, I'm good to go. But you notice I am behind the camera. What happens when I am in front of the camera? When I'm in front of the camera, what I have to do is what I just did with this camera right here. So I actually used it over the weekend and then I had to put it back. Now, when I put it back, it's not exactly in the right spot. So I have to come over here, sit in the chair. After I sit in the chair, I check out where my face is. So the point is, I like to work with what's called a rule of thirds. If you don't know what a rule of thirds is, maybe I'll make another video on that. But basically, think tic-tac-toe. So you got two lines going this way, two lines going this way. You always put the X in the first spot, wherever it is that's your favorite, okay? Now, my eyes need to be on that top tic-tac-toe line or in the intersection where this line would meet with this line. So by putting it here, I'm able to move around. I'm able to watch on my monitor, which is what I glance at every once in a while, and I try to make sure my eyes are here. So for my head, I basically am up close to the top here, okay? Fixing my hair. I'm up close to the top here, all right? And that puts my eyes on the rule of thirds. So what I gotta do is I gotta sit down in the chair and then I gotta go back and forth and back and forth until I get it just right. I'll have the camera set up kind of correctly. I'll loosen this up. Oh, it slipped out. Now I have to start all over and I have to go back and forth. So I have to tighten it up, get it right. Oh, it's not level. Get it this way. No, it's not level. Up too high until I can get my face exactly where I want it. Then I tighten this down. Well, I hate to tell you, but that's a really hard way to make it work. What I really need to do is to be able to do microscopic movements. And they have tripods like that, but they're $300, $400, $500, $800. Now, what I ran across is a new tripod that is what they, instead of a ball head, they call it tilt and pan. So let me show you that head, and then we're going to put it on, and I'm going to show you how easy it is for it to work. This is the tilt and pan head. Basically, you can go forward and back, you can tilt it like this, and you can rotate it. Your body doesn't have to follow like mine seems to want to. If I tilt it like this or like that, like this or like this, or you could rotate it, all right? Now, that's what these three handles do. And once you get them into the right place, you turn it and lock it down. And to release it so you can move it, let's say, up and down, you loosen it and you go up and down. Here, let me show you closer. Here's that tripod head a little closer. So let me first show you. It's got three handles. One is for left and right, one is for up and down, and one is for rotating around. So let's take the camera off of here and put this head on. Now I'm going to keep it on so you could watch, all right? So for safety's sake, in order to do this, I actually remove the camera from the head. So I loosen this up, and then the camera comes off, and I set it down on the table in front of me. So now most tripod heads actually will loosen up. So this will go left and right, all right? And if I loosen this, this will go round and round. So yours should do the same thing. This is a small rig. So I'm going to tighten this up. Now, if I loosen this, it will come off of the stem of the tripod. And that is what your tripod looks like if you're able to get the stem off. So I took off the small rig, whatchamacallit, head right there. Let's get it to focus. So that's the small rig head. It comes with a leveling screw. Now, I'm going to put this one on in its place. So this has a screw here on the bottom, and this has a receiving screw. Now, this came with an adapter, so I can put it on the thick tripod, or I could put it on the, let's say, another tripod head. So it does have the adapter. Now, I just turn this around, and I turn it until it seats. Okay, now you don't have to make it super tight. Now, you've got the three handles. So this one handle, if I loosen it up, it will go up and down, okay? And then I tighten it down. So the camera will be sitting right on here. Then if I loosen this one, the camera will go, and I kind of like, leveling itself out. And then if you loosen the bottom one, then you're able to go left and right. So if I go to sit in the chair, which would me being back here, you can kind of see my face. Now, if I'm not in alignment, I can actually just loosen this one and then raise it up a hair, raise it down a hair. The other ones don't change. And that makes it easy for me to go over to the camera, raise it up or down. I find something to spot in the background, like the blue lights back there on this side, the blue lights back there, okay? And I just move it up and down till I know what it is. Now, when I set this on the tripod out in front of me, I actually will loosen this and I'll bring all the handles out so they're facing the front. So now let's put a camera on here and see how that works. So I'm gonna put a nose heavy camera. So this is the E10 from Sony, and I have a Sigma lens on here. And it comes with, this is my favorite plate. Let me get this in front of you so you could see. All right, so that plate is a Manfrotto style plate, and it just snaps in. You just pop it on, and it locks in. So now, let me turn it around so you can see, okay? So this will release the camera, and you can leave that plate on. So I could take this and walk around, take it to your house, take it to my house, then I can come back and put it in here, okay, snap it on, and it snaps right on, okay? Now, I don't have it all tightened down right now because I just got this out of the box, so I'm going to have to bring this to the point where I'm tightening it down. When I want to straighten this camera out, and I'm sitting in all the way over here, and the camera's over there, all I have to do is come to this lever here and raise it up or down by loosening this handle. Now, it isn't the smoothest thing in the world. This is not like a $500 one where you can actually just turn it micronically, but you just loosen it, you raise up and down, tighten it, and then you're set. Now, if you have to go left or right, you loosen this one, and you go left and right. So this is more designed for the person in front of the camera. And you can't be resetting this up every time you want to come here and make a change. So if I take this to your house, I put it back on here, and it's, oops, it isn't right. Like here, this is a close-up. And with this close-up, if it's not exactly right, my head's going to be out there or down here. So what I need to do is come back over here so I could show you. I need to come over here and basically just loosen this handle right here. And now I can go up and down. And if I'm careful, I'll do it very smoothly. And if it's not smoothly, it's very easy to fix. So I'm not going to do this, and I'm not going to get the tilt out of whack by going back and forth. So there's a control for each one. Now, you might find that interesting, you might not. But for me, it's not expensive. This is like $60, $70. I'll put a link to it. Let's get this up so I could show it to you a little closer. This is what this tripod head looks like. A little bit on the closer side. I think it's either $60 or $70. So I'll put a link to it. It comes from Adorama. And I think they're an exclusive dealer for this tripod. So this gives me control on three different axes. It gives me the quick mounting plate, which is another thing that you kind of need to learn to do. You need to standardize, because I've got like six different cameras, only four are running right now, and three of them have this same mounting plate before I learned not to be buying tripod heads that have different mounting plates. So the mounting plate that comes on this one is a very standard one. It's originated by Manfrotto. I'll even put a link to that in case you haven't found yours and you lost yours. So I recommend this. This is the box that it came in. It comes from Adorama, they're the exclusive dealer. And I think as a content creator, it's going to do magic for you. You can take the camera off, go around the world, come back, put it on, and everything's in the same place. And if you jarred it or moved something, all you've got to do is loosen one of the handles, just do your little microscopic, minute movement or fine-tuning so you can get it right back to where you want. And that becomes critical and very important. It's a little bit cool, too. Kind of looks like the Starship, Star Trek Enterprise. No? Okay. The biggest negatives to this is because of the price. I think it's $60, $70. I mentioned that before. I should have looked it up. It isn't the best in terms of smoothness. So turning these handles, you're going to have to get used to what it is to turn it. And it is, for some reason, it's spring-loaded. So if I reduce it, it automatically goes all the way back instead of just staying right there. But in a way, that gives you a little bit of a force against you, resistance, so that you can actually loosen it and go up and down rather smoothly, which is why I think they put that on there. So these are not going to be like machined as if you bought, a $500-$800 same thing from Manfrotto, which you could go looking for that too. It's called a tilt and pan head or pan and tilt head, tripod head. The other ones, which is this one, these are called ball heads. You loosen one screw and it goes around on a ball and that's it. So that would be the negatives. It could be a little smoother, but at the price that you got, all it does is you screw it to tighten it, you counterclockwise to loosen it. And when you do that, now you've got, all your tilts in every direction. I found you have to tighten it a little more than you would expect, then it's solid. If I tighten it up just a little bit, like with the ball head, if you tighten the ball head up just a little tiny bit, you actually get enough friction where you could move it slightly. And I thought that was the secret, just loosen it just a hair. But then one time I forgot which way to loosen it and boom, everything came crumbling down. So that is far superior to me for that type of a tripod head. So I can't think of anything negative. Oh, I keep it on this tripod because when I want to go outside and talk to you and I want to walk around and talk, I will carry the camera, probably the camera you're looking at right now. I will carry that camera out with me. And then at a certain particular time, I want to park it, put it down and talk. So I could put this out there and I can just bring the camera, snap it right on, stand in front of it and just continue, you know, without missing a beat, just lickety split. All right, that's it. See you on the next one. PeterGregg, Miami, Florida. Thumbs up, thumbs out, thumbs, ears up. All right, catch you later. Bye-bye. Love you. Whoosh.
You have just watched another PeterGregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch PeterGregg. Thank you for watching.